Well, we're back here in the garage working on the 1953 Ford Jubilee. The starter is giving us a little trouble. It won't engage. So I wanted to show you, I have a voltmeter connected. I've had some people PM me and ask me what the problem is. So I wanted to show you that when I push the button, I do get voltage to the starter. You can see 12.8, got a good bit charged battery. So definitely something wrong internal to the starter. I'm thinking it's the brushes. So I'm going to remove the starter and take it apart, and we'll take a look at it, see if we can replace the brushes. So let's get moving here. All right, so the first thing we need to do is remove the oil filter, and then I need to remove that tube right there for the air intake. Take off the big wire there. It supplies power to the starter. And then there's three bolts on the starter that need to be removed. All right, so far it's been pretty straightforward. Remove the oil filter, remove the air tube, and remove the wire. It provides power to the starter. So now there are three bolts here, here, and here. They're half inch. And remove those and we just pull the starter right out. Alright, so the bolts are out now and we'll just gotta finagle this thing out of place here. That's all there is to it. Okay, well, we'll take the cover off here, take a look at the brushes real quick and see how things look. Okay, that's off, and you can already see it's been arcing really bad in there. So the brushes are definitely not making good contact. I don't know if the camera's gonna pick it up or not. I'll try to zoom in. Yeah, it's not easy to see, but the armature in there is very scored up. Definitely been arcing, so we'll have to continue the disassembly process here. Alright, so the back bolts on the starter here are 7/16. I'll break that loose and get those out. Alright, so with these guys out, we should be able to take this right apart. There we go. And now you can see the scoring, hopefully, all over the armature here. It's all pitted. Definitely not been making good contact, so. Dig a little deeper here.
Oh, that's good.
Okay, so I got the starter part and took everything out, and I have the brushes out. These two brushes are pretty worn out. As you can see, these are the removable ones with screws on them. These two, which are not removable, I think I'm going to have to unsolder them, or I'm not sure what I have to do just yet, but you can see where these are all scored up and have been hitting the that's what all these pock marks are from, is from this these brushes here. It had hardly any pressure on them at all from the springs here that are supposed to push down on them, because there's just no brush material left. So it looks like it needs new brushes, so we're gonna have to head up and get some new brushes for this and have them in and get them installed. Shouldn't be too difficult, maybe just these two. Okay, well, I have the parts now, and Tractor Supply locally here does not stock these parts anymore. They quit stocking them, so I called all around, wasn't able to get them. So I had to order these off of a place on eBay. Came with new brushes, springs, the screws, and bushings, which I may not replace. I don't think I need those, but it came with everything you need to rebuild these starters, which is nice. So anyways, we're going to get to it here, and hopefully we have this thing going pretty quickly. Alright, so the first thing I did is I had to take these old brushes out. These are actually soldered in right in here. It's actually clamped over this wire here. This piece of metal is clamped over the brush. So I had to use a torch, heat that up, and I was able to pull that out. Same with this one over here. I was able to heat it up and pull that out. And then I took a screwdriver and sort of open these up a little bit so that I can get the new brush in, which is this one right here. I've tinned it up already, and I'll stick it right inside there, clamp it down, and re-solder it. All right, new brushes are now soldered in, and we'll continue on. Okay, so now I just pulled the old springs out. That's pretty simple. Just kind of unlatch them here like that and yank them out. Okay, with those removed, we put the new ones in just as easily as you took the old ones out. Just kind of line things up here. And just like that. Alright, so you reinstall the plate here, putting all the brushes back into place. And what I found the easiest way to do this was to take each spring and just kind of set them on the edge of each of the carriers that hold the brush, just so that they're out of the way, but they still have tension on them. Then I can put the new brush in, but you don't want any tension on the brush yet because you have to put the armature back in, so we'll work on that now. All right, so I got the brushes all back in, lined up, and take and put the spring over the brush here. So that's all there is to it. Just do each one of them this way. There you go. Now they're all in. Put the screws back in. Okay, with all the keys lined up, there's one here and one here. Get everything back into position. Just gonna put these big long bolts back in again and then tighten everything up. And it's a 7/16. You can just tighten these guys right up. Alright. Oh, now we'll reinstall this on the tractor. After I put this little plate on right here, it goes over this. And we'll be ready to go. Alright, so we put the three bolts back in. You tighten those up with the half inch. Alright, reinstall the air tube. Alright, put the oil filter back on. It's not that old. We just put that on just before winter, so we can reuse this one for a while. And now we'll reinstall the positive wire here to the starter and tighten everything up. Okay, let's see if the job was successful. Key is on, gas is on, a little bit of choke.